Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining how BGP prefers the lowest router ID as part of the BGP best path algorithm. Now, just a short reminder, please subscribe to the channel to get updates to new videos and let me know in the comments below about topics that you would like me to address in the future. If you do like this video, please click that thumbs up button. When a BGP router learns about multiple paths to a particular network destination from multiple BGP sources, it must determine which path is the best path. As we have seen in previous videos, to do so, it goes through a series of what are known as BGP attributes, and it compares those attributes of each route in a very specific order to determine which is best. If there's a tie, BGP goes on to the next attribute until the tie is broken. Now, somewhere down the line, there must be a tiebreaker. Now, if all the previous attributes are equal, the very next attribute to be examined is the router ID of the BGP neighbor from which that route was learned. So the lower router ID is always preferred. Now, like most routing protocols, BGP requires that routers have configured a unique identifier to be used for all BGP communications. The router ID for BGP can be configured in one of the following ways, and we'll be specifically looking at how it's configured within Cisco routers. First of all, we have the manual configuration option. If a router ID is manually configured under the BGP routing process, then that router ID is used for the BGP peering. We can set the router ID using the BGP router ID command as we see it here. Now, this manually set ID will take precedence over any other method of router ID determination. Now, if the router ID is not manually configured, then the router will take the highest IP address of an active loopback interface. So it automatically selects the highest IP address among all of the active loopback interfaces on the router. Now, if there are no loopback interfaces on the router, then the highest active IP address of a non-loopback interface is used. Now, that's how we determine the router ID, and that router ID will play a role in the BGP best path algorithm. So let's take a look at how that actually takes place. Take a look at this particular topology. Now, let's say that we have manually configured the router ID of both R2 and R3 to be 2.2.2.2 and 3.3.3.3 respectively. Now let's take a look at the network from the point of view of R1, and we're looking at the 30.30.30.0/24 destination network. So R1 learns about this network from both R2 and R3. Now let's see what R1 sees in its routing table. To determine the best path, BGP goes through each attribute in order. Now we'll very quickly go through those and we'll say that the weight and the local preference are identical, so those are not tiebreakers. And we also see that neither route has been locally originated, so that's not a tiebreaker. The AS path, the origin type, and the MED are also all equal. And both routes are iBGP routes, so we can't prefer one over the other, as we would have if one was an eBGP route and the other an iBGP route. Also, both have the same IGP metric, and the oldest path here does not come into play since that is valid only for external routes. So after going through all those attributes, we finally get to the next attribute, which is the router ID of the neighbor from which the route was learned. So R1 will choose the path learned from the neighbor that has the lowest router ID. In this case, it's R2 with a router ID of 2.2.2.2. And this is why we see that this route has been chosen, because we see that greater than sign here indicating the best path. Now the question remains, is this valid both for eBGP and iBGP? Well, strictly speaking, yes. However, it will be very unlikely that it'll be used as a tiebreaker between two eBGP neighbors. Why? Well, take a look at this slightly different topology. Here, R1 has two eBGP neighbors, and it's learning about the 30.30.30.0/24 network from both. Now, do you remember the BGP attribute previous to the one we're looking at today? It's the oldest external path, and I have a video about that that you can take a look at. Now, this oldest external path doesn't come into play at all in our previous example because the two neighbors we were examining were iBGP peers. In this case, however, we have two eBGP routes, and R1, based on that BGP attribute, will install in its routing table the route that it learned first. Now, it's very difficult to tie in this attribute. It's highly unlikely that both R2 and R3 will have informed R1 of their path to the 30.30.30.0/24 network at exactly the same time. Now, I don't know with what accuracy the BGP router maintains the time at which a route is learned. However, it is only if R1 considers that it has learned about the destination network at exactly the same time will it consider it a tie. And only then will it go on to check the router ID. Now, in the highly unlikely event that a tie does take place, only then will it choose the lower router ID as a tiebreaker. And now remember, this is the case only when we have two eBGP peers that are advertising the same network. Now, this is expected behavior based on the definition of BGP. However, I have never seen this happen, and it's very difficult even to replicate in a lab environment. Now, you would think that the lowest router ID is the ultimate tiebreaker. Since the router ID is unique in a BGP topology, you can never have a tie for this particular attribute. But actually, it is possible to have a scenario where two routes can be learned from the same BGP peer, thus resulting in a tie for the router ID. This is also a highly unlikely and a highly specialized scenario that I won't talk about now, but I'll describe it in detail in the next and final video in this series on the BGP best path algorithm. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.